grenade on Squatfic. Of course, it lands on one of the players without armor.
Oh, taps it. He just runs into the wall of the big garage there, and it's starting to look like Coldy might have been able to pick up that frag, but Tapsin is able to pick his head off and find himself that kill.
Right, so it's one early one, plus one for big. They need a great start. This is a long road of recovery. This is a great first half for Team Spirit. He knows.
Yeah,
he was there. We'll be right back.
still first thing. So last time I did this, the last video we had, we went over something called JSON-LD, which is a way of saying the JavaScript object rotation linked data. It was like a way of structuring information to make sure that if you pass something, you knew what to parse and how to check information from it. I was talking to a few people on Mastodon, and they mentioned the point that it's you only need to parse JSON-LD strictly if you're doing like strict stuff with it, and most implementations don't. They just kind of stuff everything into like the giant object and just call it a day, which makes sense. Now the JSON-LD parser.
Yay.
What I'm going to do here, we're going to start going deeper into activity streams itself and see how we can start parsing things. That said, I'm going to switch the window. Yeah, I have a simple, lightweight header here. This is how I would wrap an object. So we'll have these things called activities. Activities represent, like, literally what I mentioned before. If, you know, Clark wanted to post something and they just dropped a post there, or things of that nature. Earlier, before I started the stream, I put up picture. Yeah. This, you're not going to be able to see this thing. But the underlying gist is that this document here kind of represents that. Like, an actor, a person who did it, represented either by a website or domain or URI, that's their thing. Like, my personal actor would always be jackie.wtf. The summary of the action would be something that's presentable, ideally for the client that's representing it. If the client is capable of parsing actor information and like pulling more information to the site, they could like go to my site, get my site title, and say I posted, you know, jackie.wtf, posted set image, or that they could do more work on the object that's not posted. Looking at that here, like, the summary is giving like human readable information. Like, the machine doesn't know who Martin is, or what a Martin is, or what an image is, just looking at this text. We just know that a particular action, or a particular type of create, had an actor whose URI is defined here, and object that was defined here. There's all these quotation marks for C++ and wrapping. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna define our activity, which kind of highlights what we've mentioned already so far. Yo, this is actually using an outdated form. So, because in an earlier part of this library, we had... Yeah, this is using Q. Let me make sure we use similar things here. So, our representation of objects, which is const read only. So, some of my ambitions with doing this is to help... is to make it simpler for other projects to pick up. And this is kind of going with the Dropbox mode of approach and implementing the things. Like, they, as far as I remember, they gave a talk about how they wrote one C++ core library and it binded down to the Android and iOS clients. So they just have to wrap things and they didn't have to worry about too much client work, which is good. You have like a infrastructure client team and then you have like a client team that gave more UX and like the other bits and pieces. Activity, static activity, parse. You know what? We're gonna make this a little bit easier. We're gonna do an extend from document. Alright. I am not 100% sure this won't work. But that's why we write code. To see Google. So, I can do up here. Actually, this is not how I want to implement this. That's fine. So, for those not familiar with C++, this is considered a header guard. It is possible for you to have like one source file include another header, and the header include the same header, and it'll create like a bad loop which will cause the compiler to fail. This is a way to prevent that from happening. Those of you who are familiar with Elixir, I don't know they do this in Go. You can't do this in JavaScript. Using is a way to like reduce the import path for an object or a class or whatnot. It's similar to the form in Elixir. So firstly, we're going to define a constructor. This. We're just going to pass it the same essential document. Real talk. Oh, I mentioned in my other video. You can find it on my YouTube. But like, I have not written C++ in so long, so this is more of like pseudo public embarrassment. that's not too bad. Instead, import that here. That's. Oh gosh. Sometimes I hate this shit. Don't you miss relative imports? Or rather, not like relative imports, but like absolute imports. You could just define it in GoDaddy. We'll get into that later. Before we continue, when I first worked on this, like it was actually annoying to like build and run a test. So I made scripts that helped me build and run a test. this is like, yeah, I voted a doc image. That's fine. I just noticed I didn't add a test for this, so we'll get to that. Oh, it shall not. We have new sources here. Maybe web is not declared. Yeah, we'll get to that. Yeah, we'll get to that. What are you talking about? It's right here. Alright. Somebody mention my mic is really low.
Ooh, that's loud. Yeah, I don't have like the greatest mic setup. I didn't want to like overwhelm you with my noise. And I don't have, like, I'm using compression. Hey, this is me just doing it for the lulz, to be honest. Sorry, and I'm just quickly changing the settings for input capture, filter, noise suppression. Let's bring it up. Is that better? That's a lot better. Excellent. Which means I can now. Nope, I can't do that. I can try. But it just gets better when my voice gets lower. Which seems to be okay. Alright. Yeah, feel free to like ping me or tell me something's going on. Word. Desktops. making sure I can see when you say something. Is that better out of the madness? Let me know. I'm keeping a close eye to chat. So, activity. So, I'm not too sure why this is failing. I'm not spelling anything wrong. Okay. I'm gonna get more aggressive with this import here. Yeah, of course not. So what's gonna have to happen? I'm gonna go ahead and write up the test for this. Alright, let's just hit the test so you can see what's going on. Just the type file. Yeah. This imports like a lot of JSON that we'll be using later on. Using a C++ framework called Q. So these things may be vaguely similar to something like JUnit, if you just did it before. But yeah, so okay. What is this like? Have written this in Rust. But that'd be no fun. I mean, it would be fun, but just not to the same extent. I just remember I had to ignore the highlighting because my Vim setup doesn't know how to pick up those setups yet. I know this doesn't make a difference, but now I'm just doing it for my own sanity. Oh,
more intimidating. I think Evo is not in this space. Close the class. Okay. No, I deleted the class. Ah. Aha. Little letters. Okay, cool. Now I got progress. Put the class name for token. Well, I did too. Alright, so boom. This is a JSON. I hate coding. That's a lie. Oh, okay. That's just something else. So it's not finding the object. Cool. Yeah, so now we're not picking up the sources for a test. It's supposed to recurse. Ah! It doesn't recurse. I'm gonna do that. Let's try that. Ooh, that's not good. Ooh, that's even worse. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna do this. And then we'll do this. Bruh. What? Yo. Okay. This is nuts. I think my camera's frozen. No. But basically, the JSON LD tests are being picked up, which is actually considered full path of something like put into the title there. But my new test here is not getting added. Ah, you know what? Do you know why? It's not named right. Okay. And voila! Cool. Alright, that's one of those tests. Somebody gotta fail. Oh, you gonna fail out here. No fail zone. Alright, cool. Alright, so we got the activity test, quote unquote, in here. And we're not gonna check out this training mode. We are going to look if we can parse. Parse correct. Let's parse the basic activity. Alright. So, what does it look like? What? How? Of course, you can't read a folder. Okay, well, that's okay. So, I'm just gonna pick up stuff here. So, what I'm hoping, and like in terms of. Oh my god. It's on the screen. In terms of implementation, we could do something like, do JSON, I think it's lowercase, star underscore document. Nope, you're a dash. Alright, you are not nice. Cool. We can do like JSON of the document, let's say doc, right? And this will take in. Autocomplete is not working. Create. Y'all saw it disappear. Like, I typed it and it disappeared. Yeah, it's. I type as fast as I speak. Three. Stream? Stream. Stream. There you go. crit. This might be people back to school or someone else, but like, the goal is to take in a document. We can parse the check as bit. So we'll do something like, let's say, Q verify. I forget, how do you verify? Doc. This is the use case for tests. If I don't know how to do something, I could just copy this line. And then wham, it works. Let's actually make sure that works. Please fail. Oh, I did it fail. Yeah, that looks like it passed. Let's be sure. So when I first wrote this, tooling for C++ code is annoying. It's frustrating, and I just. So I had to like write a few scripts to make life a little easier. Let me just run build activity. And it looks like it passed. Alright. So verification works. Now, for the heebie jeebies part, we're gonna have to I understand the namespace issue, but I'm not gonna worry about it. I'm gonna import, I'm gonna convert the activity by just doing this. Yo, I do not remember how this works. It's a big D or a little D? I don't know. That's Basa. Screamer. Two to left. Forwards over. Two colons. Delete four colons. There we go. I think. Oh no, it's not. You don't do like this. Alright. Hey man. Let's see if that works. I do it. Fail? No, why are you passing? I actually want this to break. Yeah, just to go to see something wrong. Make sure you be like a little masochistical. I don't know the word. Cool. So, the crux of what we want here now is to get these guys to make yourself something. So I think it's Q compare. We're not gonna do that. Just, everything's gonna be the assertion. Assert all the things. Activity object to equal. You know what? Nah. Say this is gonna be me. Jackie created. What did I create? Movie. Yeah, sure. I totally make movies. The object of the movie? Yo, ask them other menu. Projects. Static shot. People be sleeping well. Cool. Yeah. So I am my own object. I guess. We're gonna make this not match. So, what should happen here is that it should fail. Because, one, we need to define this method. Like, no, stop running. Run test. Ooh, look at that. Yeah. So, for those not familiar, when you don't define methods in C++, it just complains. Like, it'll let you define the reference that you're looking for, but it's like, yo, you didn't write this method body. I'm gonna just die. So it's kind of aggressive. So we got activity. Yo, you see that? I can't smell. It's really bad. We're just gonna leverage the same underlying structure we have for the document and just fetch that out. Because essentially every activity within an activity stream is a JSON-LD document, which makes it super flexible and makes it easier for interpretation. What's the other one? Type. Don't do type. Add type. And the last thing is actor. That's the first alphabetical. Don't record that. Check that to the base. And cool. So yeah, an actor. So we're gonna make a type pass, because true. And the actor is what? And the object. I would want to die for that. Anyway, I can't win. Oh, walls of doom. And that is, you leave me alone. Alright. So it's complaining about Q variant, which is fair. We have to call this to change it to. Nope, no, we don't. Nope, nope, nope. That's not true. We have pork cutout union. Ooh, I lied. What are we doing? Cannot convert the property of the string to Q variant to the that. Alright, that's fine. Which means it's complaining that it can't convert like a C string, which is like a list of. It's poo-poo. Instead of what Q has, like for UTF strings. That'll make it fly. And build a test. Everything. Ooh, we have a failure. I wonder what failed. Okay. I should change that to just passive, but I want to run. So this is false. We know why it's false. We know why it's false. What is this thing called? It's literally right there. Shock or shook? Static shook. That's what it is, nah. Man, Derek T. Dingle needs to just get the rights back to DC. Let Static Shock run the Justice League. Man, Static Shock run the Justice League. Hey, that should be making fun of Hal Gordon at the time. Alright. Wait, are you still filming? That's madness. I shouldn't be so. Project Static Shook. That's so funny to me. Little things. Okay. I'm gonna make it pass for the sake of passing. Okay, cool. Alright, so we got the gist of this. So what we can do now instead is kinda change this a little bit. We're gonna change the default verify method to not only look at the guy who did this. I think it's document that this the verify and then you do it and we'll check for our own form of verification methods. Has been verified. Has been verified. False! It's not true. So no, we don't have to do anything down here. We can just do this.
And then be happy.
Constant method declared. That's true. Yeah, you are constant. So, wait, why are you playing? Noble. Oh, that's true. That's true. We have declared. We have declared you here. But yeah, I'm about to verify people. Watch out. Alright. And this way, we don't have that whole stuff we did below. We can define our own verification for this method. And also our sound loud as well. So, come up here and just do. I'm calling that idea. Well, I mean, because I don't know. I don't know. I forget how you do this. I really forget how you do this. Like, I want to use a parent. Like, have the parent do this verification. Alright. Boom. So, what are we working on today? We're taking If you're familiar with this thing called activity streams, it's in a lot of later blog posts I've written. We're defining the objects within those streams. So, take Twitter for example. You have like a timeline of posts that just gets spat out by people. You have an inbox and an outbox. Those things are represented by objects. In this case, you have an actor, a type, and your object. Again, Twitter's form is a bit more simplistic because the input and objects is just like the actor, this you, or whomever else I can send a message, and there's just like a object, freeform text that has the information in it. Then you can get more specific as you go. What's being done right now is defining the individual activity that can just do like live verification, which is not an extension of something I worked on my last video, which is about like JSON-LD link documents. I'll put a link to this when I upload it to YouTube for all the show notes and stuff. So right now though, I'm being exposed for getting my C++ knowledge. It's been like 8 years. Like, who works on C++? We work on C++ in my job. I really don't know. So what we're gonna do is cheat. And yo, I'm pretty sure. Hold on, let me just. Nah, that's not gonna work. Alright. You know what happens when you can't figure it out? You gotta look at the internet. Because the internet knows better than we do. Give me 3 seconds. We can do this search together. Copy. Pasta. And then, oh, you can't see. Am I here? Am I? Firefox it. Okay, so you can see, this is, I think, the definition of activity streams. And you, like, I'm pulling this from the spec and trying to define it from there. Oh, come on, bro. Yeah, that's crazy. Alright, remove. Bruh, alright. It doesn't matter. Alright, I'll fix that later. Call parent method. You're a liar. That's what I did. I try that. Let's try that. I don't think I tried that. Alright, so boom. That's crazy. Alright, that worked. Low key tight. I mean, it's fine. It's fine. The number of times that it, bruh, let me switch this window. Alright. We'll be back to the source. So yeah, I typed that in and it worked. Cause you know, I can't win. Well, I mean, it worked. We had a failure.
To exchange verifies.
False, which is good, cause that means this part failed. So what that means, so what I'll do is make a huge ternary, because we love ternaries. We really love ternaries. This actor is empty. Yeah, for now, like something simple esque object. This should return true. Nope. Because we can build it.
Don't you miss interpreting languages? Oh, look at that. Now we'll pass it.
Alright. Cool. So, that's the chill, easier part. Now, the parts that gets more interesting is that there's a fixed set of types in terms of what activity streams could define.
I'm going to pull you back.
I'm trying to make sure I can find this list. Let me pull you back. Can I just make, I want to copy this, but I don't want to make a reference. Paste. I swear to God. Barry. Wait. No. Are these both the same thing? I'm tight. Alright, whatever. Boom. Nixify. Cool. so they have this vocabulary, because, you know, people love words. Cool. When's the last time you read a W3C doc? Like, just for the lulz. Just like, oh, I wonder how you define JSON. Or, why is there a site tag? Why is there a brv, A-B-B-R tag? Like, what are the point of these? So, what I'm going to look at is the core types. And these are defined as, oh my god, look at this table. How do the people who define CSS grid still use it? You know what? Not the same thing. just gonna keep scrolling. So yeah, we have objects here. There's a link concept. So what we can do, since we have the basis of an activity, or rather, we have to go back a little bit. We don't have an activity per se, but we have an object. What we can now do is extend that set object to other things, like, you know, define this itself, link, and then actually activity from here. And chat to today. What we're gonna do, we're gonna just rename what we have to object. And then so I'm trying to see, this is a little confusing. And I was trying to parse this earlier. Like, so apparently you have object and you have link. And link itself is not object, but it can refer back out to an object. That's what I was reading. Like, I saw this thing about disjoint. I'm like, what the fuck is disjoint? So, you know, what we do, we just, you know, select, search. Right? And I was like, disjoint sets. I'm like, oh shit, math. And I'm like, oh, this looks simple. And I'm like, what the fuck is a drum and a guitar? Like, this doesn't make sense. So I closed that window. And I was like, okay, cool. Put that aside. So we're going to just go down the path of an object and then go to define and serve. From here. Precise. Interesting. Yeah, and transitive activity. Yeah, we can totally do all this. And this will just have to assert that the thing is gonna. So let's write some tests. You truly, truly and honestly, the fact that I can't make another window capture right now is killing me. Yeah, so the thing is, once we can get the base activity in, we can write some initial tests, which won't be in the fully scope this time, and this at round two. We'll write out like what other kind of posts look like a pagination. Huh. I don't know if you can do this. What was collection defined from? And now I'm sorry. So one thing now with a JSON-LD, we can assert that the context comes from activity streams every time, which is not entirely true. We do have a concept, I'll show you the code just now, but we can pull to see which one is, like what underlying context is there, but we can't necessarily determine, oh my god, sorry, this video captures in the wrong spot. Yeah, which, with the tippity top. Yo, my window looks nuts, but you know, that's Windows, so I can use it. Bellissimo. Cool. So what I was just mentioning within, we have within document, concept, oh, actually not yet. That was the next thing to implement. We could pull out context systems here. God damn it. We're supposed to pull out the document and just understand like what properties are available, what is allowed to be parsed in an object, and how we can go from there. That I might do off screen and offline and then show the implementation for the next video, and this video 3. But with this doc, we can do a lot more. A lot of parsing, checking some null, variants. Cool. Yeah. So, yeah. Going back here, we're going to rename this. Oh, so actually be able to do. Objecte. I spelled it wrong. I have one check. Okay. Objecte. That looks right. I probably keep spelling wrong because I keep saying it wrong. Like, it might be a minor or matter thing right now. Hey. Cool. Ooh, look at this. Object stream. It's false. This is activity stream. I'm gonna just do this. And then. Cool. Cool. And this is a lie. Cool. So if you switch back to the Firefoxers, we'll see that. Oh, I really can't set this table. I'm about to set a Grease Monkey script to get rid of it. Look at this. Is this padding? Oh my god. Okay, so all we want, usually, is. I'm wondering, are some of these properties optional? Because we definitely need a type. Not even a question. We need types. But like, is the ID optional? Yo, I think it might be. That's nuts. Oh, well. Okay, cool. So, we're going to define... Yo, I can't trust it. See, like, this spec is not making me trust it. Okay, what did I open? This is useless. It brings me back to the same goddamn page. It's a lot. Okay. Okay. Describes an object of any kind. So it's like a ditto. The object type system. It's base type of most. Of most. 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 Okay. The other kind of objects defining. Okay. But like, can I... So I... Alright, you know what? Fuck it. What we're gonna do is, yo, this verify method might essentially do nothing. Because the only thing we can assert is if the context is the correct one. Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna just copy all of this. And yo, y'all saw me do this, but you didn't see me do it here. So. Okay, and we're gonna do this. Ooh, man, gotta love Vim. I'll just preface all this Q-berry. Because they're lazy. And we'll do this. And boom. So that plugin I use has been multiple cursors. Real talk, I'll probably use that thing like twice a day. Because like they're like, oh, import this document. I'm like, sure, gotcha. No, we're not doing that. I don't need that. That's not what I thought it would do. 5. Alright, do this shit. Is this like a new type? Alright. Alright, okay. So we're gonna try. I could just build this for a long. Oh, look at this. Failures. Alright. So I'm gonna add one more method here called type. But the thing is, I'm gonna extend it so we define the core types within this library. So there's some types that are known. But I'm conflicted about it. I'm conflicted. Yo, bro, this is mad methods. am I gonna implement all these methods? I know as I'm not. What I'm gonna do is hit this young delete. Actually, no, we're not. We're gonna Maybe it's four. Oh, I cut the A. That's why. Right. We're gonna see if we do the same thing again. Alright. Yep. Oh no. I'm gonna select all of that. Tell me where to go. Cause like now I can't put it inside. I'm just this is so oh my god. Okay, I just have to do that. Oh my god. Oh, I forgot attachment. Rip. Right. I'm just gonna. My format is broken, boy. All right. Oh, that's nuts. That's nuts. Look at this wall disaster. Okay, what did I do wrong? Oh yeah, of course. Alright, let's go in here and do this. And then this. Nah, there's a way around this. Boom. Alright, watch. So, I love Vim macros. Especially how to repeat things. Alright, so you hit QK. We'll start this. So if I go up a letter, back a word, visual select a word, boom, down, in, pay, ooh, nope, paste, and then whiz like that, and then Q. QK, watch your boy. Watch your boy. Oh shit. Nope. Oh, what happened? Okay. Bruh. Alright, let's try it again. So QK, that starts in macro. Alright, and we're in the middle of this word. We're gonna go up, back one word, visual select on, select one word, yank that, and then go down, jump, paste, release that, gonna hit that young Q. Cool. So hey, bam! Ooh! Ooh! I didn't type anything! So, now we can take this up, because you can mess these macros. So if I do like a, that was QK, now if you do QP, QP you do like, yo, hit that, but then go down to the other one. And I hit like this. So I hit QP, 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 QP. Yo, this is so great. Oh man. This only happens if you have like, oh, dozens of lines to work over. Whoever told you Vim is trash, they don't know. Oh, damn, tight. I'm not even peep that. Alright, let me go back. Alright, let's try this again. Park is T-O small. Damn. Alright, that's crazy. That's nuts. Alright, bro, you doing too much. That's me messing up. But we know it's gonna work here though. Oh, look at that. Oh, bro, come on. You can't. Oh, you're showing out. That's. Wow. Bruh, come on. Alright, whatever. Let me get a little box. Alright, yeah, so that should touch it up. But this is literally just not gonna give us anything magical. Do we have an active associate? No, because we won't not listen to this. See, this is kind of confusing to me because, like, I don't know what's needed for an object to exist, and I think the only thing is that its type has to be object. You right. to search my whole directory. Bro, keep it local. Keep it local. To be sure. Nah, no more. I don't do that to the stream no more. Do it to the object, dude. Alright. This is getting crazy. What is this? I abbreviate. If I type object, change it to object. Stop typing this. There you go. That doesn't help me from spelling it wrong though. I'm still gonna spell it wrong. Parse. Beast. Parse magic. And then Wamo. See? Didn't help. I'll fix it up later. There's a Tempo, he made a plugin for that to like have a casing when that exists. We need to find that method. Alright, where you at? Vine. No more gone. I don't know why I said to that, but I've been like cursing the entire time.
Bro.
Okay. Alright, so that runs. We got a failure. Oh, we got a failure. Build. Test. Damn. Okay. Man. Yeah, that's not right. So the issue here is that it's trying to get the activity object. The things. That's still something. I don't know where to find that. No, C++. Okay. Let's hope. What kind of field did it have? It is a show. That's what we're going to play. Alright, I'm doing a swap. I might make a script.
Bro.
Okay. What's going on here? So, any web activity stream. And they're still looking for activity. Alright, you know what that means? Where are you still seeing the word activity? I don't see this. Maybe it's inside the matrix. I call Docker the matrix. Nah. This is not what I was looking for. So, okay. I'm gonna remove the type build directory. Oh, of course I can. I've always wondered if you could like detect somebody's passwords by hearing the keystrokes and using the distance between each key if you knew one reference key. Oh my god, blah 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 blah. I don't need it. to determine their password? Because we knew, like, where, like, let's say Q, P, L, A, C, and N on, like, a regular keyboard. I say regular. I mean, like, on a US keyboard. Then, maybe, find out. That's probably, like, a lot of audio work, but... Oh, banana balls. Okay. I think I might have broken my setup.
Make.
And then test it. That's impossible. What are you talking about? This is a lie. Oh. Is that CC make? Oh, thank God! Okay. Relative deep in. Oh, sorry, in the bottom. Enable testing because people like testing, right? We love testing. I actually forgot the flag. I should just make enable a default. But it's just like extra dependence. Build test. That's a terrible move. I'm gonna change that. What I said. Wait, what? Can't go past that. Coverage for not minus because you lying, that's why. You just want me to be full dude, but that's crazy. That's crazy. What do you call this? What? Yo, CMake? It's lit, but like it's mad confusing. Build type. With bubble. Alright, build B. Alright, yay. Hey! Yeah! Okay. Man, we got these tests, but... I mean, you keep failing. I don't trust you, friend. Oh. Where's that song?
It works.
low-key, I think before I was calling test underscore activity, which is gonna fail. Yeah. Cool, but we got this verified for right now. The thing is, we don't know. Oh, we know it's the object. Verify that's failed. And we can just take a quick introspection to see why it was. Yo, that was showing you all my. That's keep showing my personal thing. Object CPP. It was good. Yo, my type. Oh, this is going the wrong way. I wonder that QD bug. Let me see what you got. I wonder that make. You got Bill. What you got? Oh, it's a create. That's crazy. Alright. I mean, that makes sense. That's what we put in there. Fixed up. Passe. All right. going to do this. And this is, it looks like a small accomplishment, but this is actually a big milestone. We have the foundation of the object. Now, we get this a little further and start defining the types into like structure types, which is exactly what we'll do next. But from now, we can define every other object and type inside activity streams. I should just look.
How long has this been a Firefox? Oh, that's kind of awkward. Yeah, I'm gonna have to work on that.
Yeah, so we can go ahead and like defining everything else. There's also activity types, which has stuff that we start to understand. Flags, dislikes, deletes, create, block, arrive. And this pushes us to the future, or just like making clients and other things that people can use. So, next thing we're gonna do right now is implement the types. Or define the core types.
Open this a little bit.
Core types, we know what they are.
Or do we?
Core types.
Object.
Wait.
You ready to begin defining these?
Oh, look at that. We might have. Oh, looks like I was trying to cheat. Cut ahead. Whoops.
Alright. Okay.
So we're gonna leave this at top here. And we're gonna have types, and this is gonna define everything else. Oh, this is actually looking a little confused. So the object we have is technically a type itself. So we'll have to pull that in, which is fine. Link. Activity. That other kind of activity. Collection.
Wait, why?
Oh, this is a individual.
Yeah, no.
So yeah, that's a word. You know what this means? I'm gonna hit that reverse on the namings and things. So we're not gonna do this. We're gonna save
fine
activity. So, again, we're copying the code over, because code is alive, it lives, it breathes, kicks and breathes, yeah, we'll just pull this into here. Witness the full force of the Jabari tribe. That's the scene in the movie when this, I think, comes on? I can't remember. And you know what happens to this? Rip! Oh. Rip! Oh my god, it's not deleted. That was weird. Actually, this is, if I bring up, that's essentially what I just did. I'm gonna make a core. But this is actually core optics. Type C plus, you don't want to try attack all these headers all the time. This reduces load. Yo, real talk, I really appreciate people who are sitting here from the beginning, because once we get into the more, like, I guess, visually interesting things, like, you know, sending UE and, like, make our own service to connect with this, you'll be like, oh, I remember, like, you know, how this is defined. I was there at the beginning. I was shooting with you in the gym. And, you know, it's that. I ain't stressing. I definitely am. I talk about it. I am stressing. yeah, these are types. And core. Yes, core defined. Core. These properties I'll worry about. Of course. I remember this being like a slight issue with these, and I didn't want to worry about it now. So you don't belong here, dude. Me and you are moving you into the core. That's real. Files die for AP. Alright. So that's not the truth. This is the truth. Right.
Okay.
This feels bueno with me. Properties. I mean, low key though, nah. Yeah, nah. Boom, boom. So we got core. And then we got extended. So we're not going to define extended today. Because that's brazical. Where's the jump to top outside, bro? Yo, this shit is crazy. So we're going to include extended, then selectivity, and then what else is there? That's like the actor. And then there's the object today. But we ain't going to do this today. We're going to be like, yo, there's zero. You won't see that. I know the types. Am I extended? How about done it? Cool. We don't have any rest of these files yet. Yet. That's rude. Wait. Ooh. Whoa. Whoa. What is this? Okay. I don't know what this means. Ooh. Level 2. Fart. Like that. And then, I see. Wow. Reading is fundamental. I mean, this doesn't have to do anything with reading, just more so typing. And do Jason LB, the HPay. And do this. Yo, you know, head guards? I should make it just a whole template for C++ files, because this is bananas. Yeah, put that in, cut that, paste it IE, and then get a C board. Yeah, looks like I got about a little over 50 minutes left. So, we're gonna leave link below. We're not gonna pop with that. There's a quick refine. Activity and coalition. Even though these will be like meta things, so it's gonna be. Oh, god damn it. There we go. And then we'll define. directory called collection. Because these are, like, there's, like, activity, and it's, like, a trist activity thing, which is, like, an appended type. So I'm like, yeah. So we'll do this.
Yes.
And then... Transitive, I guess. Oh my god, yo, words are so hard to spell. I'm gonna just, oh, look at that. Oh, what's happening? The letters are on my keyboard. Alright. Cool. Oh, what the f- Alright. You know what? The computer talks the way I want it to, and obviously, I don't know how to tell. So. We're gonna include those headers in here. Activity base. Activity. Oh, okay, so you know what I want. Alright. To make life a little easier, because the way those things are gonna be defined is gonna be a little funky. Remember, we're not defining this. It's not real. Stream, and then we're gonna do like core. And we'll have a type def. I always forget the first thing. So we'll do activity. It'll be like, I'm gonna say activity base, and we'll just type def as activity. So people can, it'll be easier to type. And then it'll be like the. Actually, I might not give you the other one. I can just find this another one. Oh, look at that. Alright. Yep. Okay. I'm just making these empty things so it's a bit easier to grasp. Oh! Too fast, too furious. Sabe. Okay, order. Alright. Collection page. Apache. Okay. I have this bad habit of taking like every E and pronouncing like it's the E with a cute accent on it. Ooh, order collection page. Okay. so then I do that. Order page. Yes, that makes sense. Yeah, I'm just putting these things in there. Something like that. And then I can simply like collection base. And then there'll be hey. Nice, cool. Is she? So object is still billing. We'll have to update the test because now it's like in a different place. Yeah, we're gonna move you. We're gonna make a new folder first called core, and then rename you to be within core. So now your true name, your real name. That's a whole conversation. Boom. I mean, if this one build, I mean, we gonna fight. You probably won't fight. Oh, look at that. Okay. Good times. Run test. Alright. To make sure that doesn't happen, let's do something real. So I'm gonna update the what do you call this thing? The directories that it's included. Oh, why is it? All right, my bad, y'all. I didn't realize like you're still looking at Firefox this entire time. So sorry about that. But. What I was saying now is that the current test failed because it couldn't find the fixture file. In a later version, I'm going to do this offline. I'm going to update it so we don't have to use fixture files, or rather this fixture header to import. We'll just import from this. But what I do need to do is at support for it to, you know what? Let's actually just do this. The wrong one. There we go. Cool. I was trying to be clever, but like, forget it. That one's weird. Okay. No, I don't need you. So, what I'm going to end up doing is doing the include directory call on each test so that they can include the test folder. But I want to only do this for a particular target. There we go. Oh, I love docs. Alright, so we're doing target. Why didn't respect my indentation? Everybody don't respond to indentation. Test Nama, and then we'll do. I guess we'll do current sorcerer, and then we'll add this stuff. Build. Okay. That doesn't feel right. Oh no. And what makes this more awkward is that we have 10 minutes in the cloud. Current source. What does this print out? Oh, am I reading this wrong? Oh, okay. Make that public. Okay. And that makes sense. Well, I think it does. So we should go to do that. Hey. Passes. That's cool. That's cool. Everything shut up. We didn't change too much code. We changed more, what do you call this thing? Just locations and stuff. Cool. So now, if we go, we're running crazy low on time. So what's gonna happen? I'm just gonna quickly jump around and start fleshing out some junk here. So this, no longer. Wait, where did that file come from? Here, yeah. And then base. Huh. I just saw that, right? Activity stream. It's like activity something. Yeah, see, so use a lot. Alright. Cool. That's fine. Activity. Activity base. Alright. Cool. So. This right here? That's rude. Don't do that. Don't be that person. Alright. Core. Because that's the directory under, right? Yes. We have activity base. No, truly, honestly, I'm just calling it activity. And we all inherit from our best friend object, right? Do you know? Sorry, just turn it up a little bit. Just a little bit. Good. I don't know, that's crazy loud. If it is, let me know.
switch to here. The Greatest Songs, which are, they're African inspired, but not in Genesis, which is Hollywood. Cool. No. This feels wrong. Core object. Hey. You do what you want. And what we'll do, we'll go up so many directions. And go to Civil Stream, Core Objects. Oh, why do I do that? These will come first. Nice and loose with this. We inherit all the existing properties. So activities is subtype. Actually, make life easy. I'm the kind of person who would put a link to the JIRA ticket when I'm working on classes. So. Instruments? What does that mean? I don't care. Oh, wait, this relates to music. Oh, shit. It really relates to music. I didn't expect that. Okay. Okay. So we're gonna do this one more time. And we're gonna do. Ooh, that looks nuts. Alright, we're not gonna do that. We're gonna do this. Whoa, okay. Alright, let's put this window, close that, edit it, and restore. Sadly to universe. But I won't, you know, spoil it. The short half of it. Whoa. So, what this looks like is wrongness. That's not supposed to happen. I have to do the classic, right? I mean, truly? Honestly? Macro time. Alright. So we're starting it. I'm gonna delete this. Add that. Escape. Add space. Escape. Cons. That's wrong. But we'll fix that. And then escape. And then hit that Q. No. Oh my god. Oh my god. I mean, I guess. And then, it's a lazy. Boom. And then, because I'm also super lazy. Boom. Alright. And. To make everything even more fun, activity takes this object. But we can make this more sane and like allow it to pull in JSON or DDoM. Nope, I don't care. Alright. So, the thing is now, what is required for an activity? They don't really tell us. We see that as an actor, an object. There's no role. Well, see, in summary, it's like an added property. Oh, man. This is what I get for trying to be valid. Let's look at the
documents.
Implementation notes. Conceptually, every object is a primary secondary audience. That's not what. Okay. Oh, so that explains this. Activities are really isolated events. Well, I hope so. Reputation is a relationship object. I'm just getting flooded by this. Bruh. Okay. Activity type, use cases, properties. Jesus Lord. The domain indicates the object applies to. The range is the type of value that it's going to have. Certain properties meant to start properties with another term. So I'm sure it's. Okay, that makes an inkling of sense. Describes one or more actors. Any single activity can mold one actor. So you're telling me it can be like a group of actors. Bro, that's actually bananas. That actually changes everything. Which means this, well, it doesn't change this. This is still a variant. But the definition, yeah, it's actually bananas. Okay. So what's not gonna happen today is us implementing that. What will change is this. And I'm gonna change this to a few variants of this. I'm not sure if that's defined. Like, not defined as part of cube variant. It'd be weird. Target. Target. Yo, this is not alphabetical. Oh, it's not alphabetical. Because what would you have? The precise way your target's depending on the type action described. Target. Okay, an activity can have more than one. Okay. I should assume that everything could be like multiples. What did I just click? Okay, result. Result. Yo, this is really not alphabetical order. The result. Okay, singular. Alright, we're not being weird. Origin. Alright. Singular. Instrument. Oh, so, okay. Instrument is not necessary. I'm thinking it doesn't have music. But, like, if somebody made music, technically the instrument that you use to make music would be a musician. If you did a picture, or you made a picture, or took a picture, your instrument would be the camera. Okay. So if you're Thanos, and you're trying to kill out the universe, the instrument would be the freaking gun. I need to get one so badly. Alright, let me be out here. Which, now conceptualization makes a bit sense. Like, there's always an amount of actors, and an amount of objects, and there's gonna be an amount of instruments, which... Wait, can it be more than one target? Oh, yeah. Actually, no, man. I ain't taking that chance. Look it up. Yep. You know what? Let's just do that. Yeah, I'll worry about spacing. Who spells anymore? Spelling is whack. If you can't spell a word, there's a good chance you might pronounce it wrong. Like, I couldn't say the word for the outside of a PC, like the casing. I used to say chassis. I think it's chasis. It's something like that. I can't. I
like, so they get a shell for a PC. This is just so I can click through and just like, oh, what does this do? Alright, so boom. We're not gonna implement this today. That's my work. Because in order to do that, we'll define like what origins look like. Actually, we can glance at it now, but it describes indirect object for activity from which the activity is directed. So, like, if I'm sentencing to you, then it's I'm the origin. I guess. So I label the post from the state to this. Got it. Oh, but necessary. Okay, okay, got it. Bruh. domain, this only lives within. Wait, does this not have a type? That's crazy. These things don't have types. Whoever told you types are bad, lied to you. Properties marked as functional can only have one. Okay. So you know what that means. Alright. Yo, this thing is really in alphabetical order. Like, did they make this by hand? I wasn't talking to you, Echo. Alright. The domain indicates the type of the object, the property types. Okay, so object, which is almost everything. The range indicates the type of value that the property value can have. So, any URI. Just like this. Type URI. Good to know. Certain properties to make mark the subproperty of. That's crazy. Instance an actor. That's a false. Okay, properties can mark this functional, can only have one value. Alright. Functional value. Alright, so boom. I mean, that's it. I mean, it's not the... Because you know what? There's no love in the wild. Oh, this is dumb. It's not that it's dumb. It's just that... It's dumb. So... what we're gonna do is... go through the ones that we know... I'm just trying to determine what's good with this. Yo, this is nuts. I mean, this is the same gist on top. Yeah. So, if you really look at this, like, all of these properties, like altitude, that's usually just check-ins. Sorry, my audio sounds a little loud.
Shadow recap after we covered today and make a nice sweet blog post and upload this video for y'all to watch later. Real talk, applause to everybody who came to the stream, popped in and out. I understand it was like going in and out, and there's some times I didn't have the window open. I'm gonna do the split screen more often, so it's more respectful to y'all. Sorry. But yeah, thank you for sticking in for second stream so far.